Benjamin Ednabone, you have been charged with losing the NeighBens recast quiz battle.
Not guilty.
Get it, mate. You'll be held in custody until your lawyer, Gerald Rebecca, turns up to represent you.
Yeah, give me some. Give me Samantha Fitzgerald. Get Samantha Fitzgerald on the phone.
I'm Ben.
And I'm Ben.
And we are
the Neighbours.
The Neighbours.
Well, Ben, I've got a bone to pick with you.
Straight to it. Go on.
Sling me into jail and you don't even come and visit me?
I'm here now, aren't I?
Yeah, but you know, it took me begging, borrowing, visiting orders. I mean, me mate down the road, Patrice, in cell number 7, she's had about 27 visitors, and that was just before breakfast this morning.
I'm sorry, I did arrange for Toadie to be your lawyer.
I'm not sure I can keep you out of jail.
Yeah, that says it all, babes. That says it all. We need to get me out. I can't cope all this gruel. How am I ever going to win a quiz when all I've got to eat is gruel and blinking dodgy biscuits?
Oh.
I mean, I'm not going to lie, I am enjoying a little fire extinguisher grog.
Well, it's not much better for us on the outside, then. We're back in lockdown here in the UK, so, you know, at least you get your meals made for you.
Tough titty phalanges, I'm in lockdown all the time, thanks to you and your rogue little chain reaction. Anyway... We shall talk no more of it.
So, because you are in jail, we thought we'd have a quiz themed on neighbours in lockdown. So we've got three questions each.
Three questions.
Based on the courtroom dramas and the prison dramas of our favourite Ramsay Street residents, neighbours in lockdown.
We're going on lockdown, ladies.
One of Neighbours' naughtiest young whippersnappers, Michael Martin, son of Philip, stepson of Julie Martin, who he tried to drown in the hot tub.
You know if Dad left any money for me? Nothing. You just relax, Mum. Relax.
Oh, it was all very Hamish back in the 90s.
You're dead to me.
Damn!
Rick Alessi helped Michael Martin escape prison. How did they do it?
Rick visited Michael in prison and got him to dress up as a woman and pretend, I think he didn't he pretend that Michael's his girlfriend and they just walked out the prison gates.
How do I look? Oh, I know I'm not going to win any beauty pageant or anything, but will I fool the guard in the gate?
Well, that depends if he's really, really old and half blind.
Thanks, you do wonders for my confidence.
He was like the least convincing woman ever.
Man, I feel like a woman.
Oh, God. But yeah, and it was a mission to save Debbie from the clutches of Darren Stark.
AKA Lucas Fitzgerald.
Can I help you? Yes, you can, mate. You can start by opening the cash register.
Darren!
But it all ended in a dramatic gun showdown, didn't it, in a petrol station.
Down!
Stark!
Crikey, it was very dramatic in those days. And then Michael ended up nice in the end, didn't he? he turned out all right.
Yeah. That was a bit of a disappointment, wasn't it? A reformed Michael Martin.
It would have been nice if he popped back every now and again to just wreak a little bit of havoc, you know. I mean, Paul still is step uncle.
Yeah, there is a connection there.
Yeah.
You're learning, Ben, you're learning. Your chains are getting better.
I still defend my chain, but anyway. But also Darren Stark, he became a reformed character as well, didn't he? I know Carl might disagree.
Well, you're really something else, aren't you? You sit there and you judge everyone. And you judge me.
They have a habit of turning really good, nasty characters good.
I know.
Apart from Paul Robinson, he still gets nasty every now and then.
All right. What's Therese been telling you?
So, Ben, we often make fun of Toadie's success in the courtroom.
Do you need a lawyer? A smart lawyer?
Just had a brainwave. Occupational hazard with top lawyers like me.
A lawyer who can persuade a jury?
Even if you entertain the slightest doubt, you must return a verdict of not guilty.
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 Who gets result?
I beg you, please do not let one awful mistake destroy this man's life.
You are sentenced to 20 years imprisonment.
5 years imprisonment.
To a 3-year jail term with a 2-year non-parole period. I sentence you to 4 years at Warren Correctional Facility for adults. And I sentence you to 10 years.
6 years imprisonment.
3 years imprisonment.
Well, I think that went pretty well.
Then call Rebecca Law, 0800 guilty.
I don't appreciate sending innocent people to prison, Mr. Rebecca.
But once he did manage to get a case dismissed. Name the lucky defendant.
It's got to be someone who didn't actually do it.
Well, that Tony sent a lot of people who didn't do it to jail.
Paula's already called a lawyer.
What? Who?
Jared Rebecca. He's with her now.
Brilliant.
Paul, I am sure he is going to look
after her. Oh, yeah, like everybody else who ends up in jail on his watch, hey?
Oh, my word. This is going to be someone really random, isn't it? Oh. Was it Harold? Harold. I'm going to go with Harold.
No.
No, Val.
If you'd gone for one step down the family tree and gone for David Bishop, you would have been correct.
Whoa, what did David Bishop do apart from bore everyone to death?
David Bishop is a much loved character from the Neighbours past, thank you.
That's true.
It was all to do with Paul. Paul had kind of set David up for some sort of fraud, corruption. David was taking the fall for it. He was in court. And Toadie.
Was he on work experience or something that day?
No, but Toadie, for once, did his job and saved an innocent man from jail.
The warrant was for number 34 Ramsay Street, and Mr. Bishop resides at number 24 Ramsay Street. Therefore, I have little option but to ask that the evidence collected at number 24 Ramsay Street be excluded and the case be discharged.
Case dismissed.
Unfortunately for David, if Toadie had stuck to his form and got David sent to prison, David wouldn't be dead. He wouldn't have got on that plane. He would have been in jail.
Good luck, everyone. And remember the safety drill. May God be with us.
And he'd still be alive today. So,
this is an outrage!
It certainly is.
The bishops are a bit naughty at the best of times, aren't they? I'm sure Kerry Mangle got arrested for protesting quite a few times. She was married to Joe, who was, you know, wrongun.com. Blinking Sky got done for murder. Even though she wasn't guilty. I mean, Serena was destined for a stint in Goodwood, wasn't she?
Yeah, she was always involved in some sort of murky underworld, wasn't she?
Oh, yeah, she was.
I'm not talking about Connor O'Neill's pants.
Disgusting!
But didn't Harold once get suspected for armed robbery?
He attempted to murder Paul Robinson, didn't he?
So yeah, they're all crims. I mean, yeah. We talk about the Robinsons being corrupt, the bishops, holier than thou bishops. They're the ones running the criminal underworld of Ramsay Street.
They are. Harold is the original Tony Soprano.
He even slept with the fishes at one point, didn't he?
He slept with Fisher from Home and Away.
I've known many boys like you over the years.
Oh, don't know about that.
Pretend it hasn't happened.
No, it's what the mafia say. You're going to sleep with the fishes and they kill someone. Harold literally did that.
I'm not down with mafia lingo. I'm a good boy.
Oh, I learned a lot from Rocco.
Welcome to my family.
I'm not Carmella in the habit.
Yeah, back in the habit.
Yeah. Okay, this is an easy one for you, Ben. When my favourite gal, Steph Scully, got sentenced, the night before, someone asked her to run away with them. Who asked Steph to run away with them?
Now, I'm assuming this is the second time Steph got sentenced.
We're not talking euthanasia, we're talking Ringo Gate.
Ringo game. Okay. Easy one. Lucas Fitzgerald begs Steph to run away with him.
You could go anywhere. Just disappear. You, me and Charlie.
And who could blame him? Because, you know, you'd want to run away with Steph Scully and just live your life on the road with Steph. It'd be a grand life on the back of her bike.
I can just see the picture in your head. It's you and Steph on a bike together. Thelma and Louise on a motorbike.
I feel like I'd be like Stephanie Zanoni in Greece too. She'd be my Michael.
The cool rider.
Cool rider.
Cool enough.
She can burn me through and through. With Lenny chasing after us down the road. No. But anyway, yeah, me and Steph Scully doing a Greece too. That's the dream, isn't it?
All right, your question, Ben.
Oh, here we go.
Who forced Dylan Timmons to commit armed robbery?
This is a really nasty question. Because it's a random guest character.
I'll give you a clue. Their nickname is linked to a marsupial animal.
Roo?
Is that your final answer?
Yeah, Roo.
That was a bloody good guess. Reuben Roo Houseman.
To pity when it comes to his mates, he's a dog. Let him go, Roo. You see, that's half your problem, Dil. You never want to share the good times.
And didn't he get arrested at his own memorial service as well?
He did, yeah. He faked his own death.
Was it in the plane crash?
Yeah. Got arrested, and him and Stingray got sent down. I guess he was representing them in court.
Toady Rebecca.
Yeah.
Whoever gave him that piece of paper with a degree on it. Which two Ramsay Street residents got banged up in a cell overnight with two hookers called Simone and Rhonda?
Helen Daniels and Dorothy Burke.
Correct.
How do you do? How do you do? Looks like we're going to have some fun with these two, Rhonda.
Why were they banged up?
Because Helen had had some kind of speeding incident in a car and was defending herself in court. And Dorothy got a bit noisy in the courtroom on Helen's behalf, and they both ended up in contempt of court.
I find you in contempt. You ought to be arrested.
If you do that, you can arrest me too.
Arrest Mrs. Daniels as well.
Weren't they drag queens?
No, they were prostitutes.
Did they end up making like really good friends with them?
Yeah, they ended up being quite chummy, I think.
Well, now we're friends, let's have a game, shall we? How about charades? I'll go first.
They couldn't convince Helen to join the business.
First drink driving, then jail. Now you're befriending this type.
Well, you know, I mean, she'd never been tempted after Daphne's stripper days. Well, she was painting, wasn't she? Not Ned painting. She wasn't doing her own fandangle, was she?
Oh, oh my word, Ben.
I mean, what goes under the Bungle Bungle stays in the Bungle Bungle.
This painting won't be like a photograph. You see, I want to capture your essence, your spirit, more than your physical appearance. Now, will you try and hold still for me, please?
But what I loved about it was the fact that they put Helen Daniels, who's very prim and proper, with Dorothy in a cell with these two prostitutes, and there was no judgment.
Well, she was always taking in every waif and stray that came into the street.
I'm surprised she didn't offer them room and board.
And number 26 into a brothel. She became the Madam of Ramsay Street.
Now that's a spin-off I would love to see. Forget the Moulin Rouge. the Daniels Den of Iniquity.
Poor James.
Decadent, immoral, harlot, slut.
Goodness gracious me. Sorry, Helen. I do apologise.
Sorry. All right, Ben, so basically you've been sentenced to another episode of failure, but maybe this could save some face.
It's a nice face. It does need saving.
I know, yeah. Who spent a few days in prison for a backlog of unpaid parking tickets?
This face ain't getting saved anytime soon. Unpaid parking ticket. Carl, Susan, Billy.
All these well-known storylines you're referring to.
Lou, Sienna.
No, all right. You're going to need to pick one.
Ned Parker.
It's your it's your favourite character, Marlene Kratz.
Not bad for an old hover.
I'm ending this right now. Take me back to my cell. Take me back to my cell.
Come on now, Ben. Calm down. At least it wasn't a Holly the Dog question.
It might as well have been. Tim Collins has got nothing on you.
Time for the crowning.
Has anyone got that bomb from the last series, please?
Oh, blimey, damn, twice in 2 weeks.
Oh, sorry, Ben.
Oh, bad luck always comes in threes.
Dum, dum, dum.
Well, maybe you are cursed. Maybe that's why you've had such a terrible run.
So thank you for watching. Please subscribe, like and comment below and give us a follow on Twitter as well. And we will see you next time.
See you later.
Isn't that the dinner bell ringing?
No, there's a riot. I've got to go.